good morning, afternoon, and or evening. This is not the first time that I have presented for a virtual conference, but this is the first time that I've actually recorded my presentation for a virtual conference. So it is a little different for me in that I'm not interacting with a live audience. I'm Dr. Tatum from Fried Hardeman University. I'm the director of our iLearn program, which is helping our gen ed teachers integrate technology into their classroom. It's part of our quality enhancement plan, which every university, which is in the South, which is part of the Southern Association of Colleges and Schools, has to have a quality enhancement plan, and ours is the iLearn program. I'm also an associate professor of education for Fried Hardeman. My Twitter handle is here on the first slide, Dr. M.M. Tatum. I've also given you a link to TwitCasting Live, which is what I'm going to be talking about in this session, and also a link to my actual TwitCasting, where all of my different shows are housed that I have done over the last several years. It's an honor to be a part of K-12 Online 2014, which is taking place October the 20th through 31st, 2014. My session is part of the Stories for Learning, which is the week of October the 20th to 24th, and my session is actually taking place on Friday, October the 24th. I want to remind you of the hashtag for this online conference. It's #K12Online14. A little bit more about myself. As I said, I'm the director of the iLearn program. I've been an associate professor of education since 2006. I currently teach two online classes along with directing the iLearn program. I teach EDU 642, Advanced Technology for Educators, and also EDU 613, The Principalship. I received my EDD from Auburn University in Educational Administration back in March of 98. I've been involved in educational technology ever since my first master's level class at the University of South Alabama in 1983, which was EDM 510, Microcomputing Systems in Education. So we're going to be talking about TwitCast. Now, there is a term, TwitCasting, and this is actually the definition of TwitCasting, using Twitter to comment on or summarize an event while it is ongoing by restating what a speaker has said, posting quotes, or adding original reflections. The TwitCaster plays a similar role to a sports commentator. Now, there is now actually a company called TwitCast, and that's what I'm going to be talking about for the next few moments. And again, the link to TwitCasting Live is at the bottom of the screen, us.twitcasting.tv. Now, the nice thing about TwitCast is that you can use TwitCast with either your Twitter login, which is what I do because I use Twitter for my professional learning network. Some people use Facebook for theirs. So the nice thing is you can also log into TwitCast with your Facebook login. So if you happen to log in with Facebook, this is how it looks. And again, if you log in with Twitter, this is the page that you will see. Now, the nice thing about TwitCast is you can use it with a Mac or PC. And in my case, I use it with either my iMac or my MacBook. But you also have the ability to do it with mobile devices. You can use a smartphone app. Now, they're creating apps for the tablets as well. Now, right now, I use my smartphone app on both my iPhone and my iPad, but I've been notified that they are coming out with the app for the tablets as well. You can use Live on iOS or Android. And the picture to the left is what it looks like for an iOS device. The picture to the right is what it looks like for an Android device. Now, you use TwitCasting Live to do your TwitCast on a mobile device. Now, to view it, you're going to use what's called the viewer. So you either get the viewer for iOS if you have an iPhone, or you get the Android viewer. And this is used for viewing the TwitCast. Now I'm going to back up just a moment. If you're doing it on your MacBook or your PC, you're simply going to go to twitcasting.tv, and as you can see in this screenshot, you're looking at my site, and you have the ability to click broadcast, and that's what you would do to start broadcasting. And so again, if you're going to do it with a mobile device, you use TwitCasting Live, and to view it, you use TwitCasting Viewer. Now I'm going to stay on this page for just a moment so you can see the links. Now the easiest thing is just simply to go to the App Store, type in TwitCasting Live, and the app will pop up and you'll download it. It's a free app. Again, the viewer is free as well. If you have an Android device, you simply go to the Google Play Store, type in TwitCasting, and again, when you type it in, make sure you look for the green bird for the viewer and the blue bird for the live. Now, one nice thing, I have been talking with the Moy Corporation, which is the owner of TwitCast, and they currently are housed out of Japan, but they're in the process of making a presence in the U.S. And I have worked with them, and they now have a category called education. So you're looking at a screenshot of what the screen looks like when you get ready to start a TwitCast. So you go ahead and choose education for your live category. Then whatever you want your subtitle to be, you put in your subtitle. You also have the ability to do a hashtag. And so in the case of our current online conference that we're taking part of, the hashtag would be #K12Online14. And probably on the Friday of my presentation, even though I won't actually be interacting with the folks, I will probably do a TwitCast that day with this hashtag and talk a little bit more about TwitCasting on the Friday of my presentation. And so that is real neat that they now have the education category. Now, a tweet is sent out when the TwitCast begins, and so the people who are following you get a tweet, and if they want to watch it live, then they just click on it and they start seeing you talking live. Now, the nice thing about TwitCast is they archive the video. And so you have the ability, if you're doing it for your school, then parents, teachers, whomever the audience might be, can click on it and watch it in the archive state. And I'll talk a little bit more about that in just a couple of moments. Now, you do want to remember to use a hashtag. And in our case, again, for the conference, it's #K12Online14. So if I was TwitCasting for this particular conference, that's what I would use. Now you see a screenshot of the TwitCast that I do for my 642 class. So this happened to be a TwitCast that one of my students did. So she happened to use the hashtag TwitCast, the hashtag ISTE, and also the hashtag EdTech, and our class hashtag FHU EDU 642. And so I had the ability, if I wanted to, just to click and watch her live as she was doing the presentation. Now there's many things that you can do with TwitCast from a school aspect. You can share with the community. So you can let the community know what the school hashtag is and pick a particular day that you're just going to share out things dealing with the community, especially if your building is used a lot by the community. You can get on like on a Friday and talk about the way in which it's going to be used the next week. You also can use TwitCast to share with parents, grandparents, or guardians. Now, I will say what you're seeing a screenshot of right now is my site, and this is my live history site. And so as you can see, I've got four tabs. So I have about, 9 times, I have about 36 episodes that are currently out there. Now, if you go in and give it a title, then they will not delete it. Now, what I do, some of mine I keep up there for a while, and then you have the ability to go in and actually delete it as well. Now, if it is a presentation that you've done and you haven't gone in to give it a title, and there's not very many people that have watched it, then over a period of time they will take that video away. But even in that case, to me, TwitCast is a great thing to use because you have the ability to share things. You don't have to worry about the recording aspect or what. All that is being done in the background. So not only do you have the ability to share with parents, grandparents, or guardians, you can also use TwitCast as a form of professional development. And what I do, especially with my graduate students, is as I talk to them online with things during the class, every Friday I go on and share up-to-date information with them about whatever that topic is. So if you have a faculty meeting on a Monday afternoon and Wednesday something comes across your desk, either in paper form or online, you can do a quick TwitCast and share that information with the faculty in reference to what you talked about during the faculty meeting. Now, this particular screenshot again that you see here is what it looks like after you've done it. So where you see week 7, spring 2014, that's where I've gone in and given it a title. So it would not go away because I've given it a title. Now, I also have the ability you see on the screen where it says delete. So if I wanted to delete it or even unpublish the video, I could do that as well. Now, you also have the ability to download the movie. So if you wanted to download all of them, archive them on your own computer, and share them either in Dropbox or whatever, you would have the ability to do that as well. And I've also already mentioned a little bit about professional development, but using TwitCast for ongoing and systemic PD is a great thing to do. As a classroom teacher, I could use it for classwork and homework updates. And going along with that, I can also use TwitCast for a weekend review. So much like I do with my graduate students and do a TwitCast every Friday, classroom teacher could say, okay, parents, students, every Friday I'm going to do a TwitCast before I leave to sort of summarize what we've talked about this week. And so it could be a 10-15 minute summary. Now, one thing I have noticed with TwitCast, I can usually do a TwitCast for about 20-30 minutes and it not start over with me. Now, I will say about TwitCast, the group that uses it the most are tweens. But when I go to the TwitCast site, I really don't pay attention to what's there. I just go to my site and go broadcast, and I start doing a TwitCast. So even though there may be some tweens that use it, if they're not following you, then they really don't see your TwitCast anyway. And I will also say this about TwitCast. I've not seen any inappropriate things on TwitCast. Most of the things that I've seen with TwitCast is either tweens that are using it, much like Facebook, as a way to sing and share things that they're singing, or how to put on makeup and different things like that. But they now realize that teachers from K-20 are using it. So as I said earlier, you now have the category of education. so they really see the use of it in an education setting. You can also use it for academic club updates, various organization updates, sports and club updates. And what I've done with each screen is I've just taken screenshots of different ones of my graduate students who have used TwitCast for part of one of their assignments where they had to record a TwitCast. Now, if I was a building principal, I would also use TwitCast for bad weather updates. And TwitCast would be a great way for teachers to communicate with the students even during bad weather, especially if the bad weather closed school for 2 or 3 days in a row. They could share information about what the students have learned up to that point so that once they get back together face to face, they can pick up where they left off. Now, I do have a blog, and I've given you a link. I used a shortener for the link, an FAQ shortener. So if you type this into your browser, it'll take you to Thoughts and Ideas from Doc Tatum, and it'll take you directly to the blog about collaboration with TwitCasting. And on that site, I have several things that I've shared about TwitCasting. I've also done a compilation about TwitCasting, which I was going to share at the end of this presentation, but this presentation can only be 20 minutes in length, and I'm getting close to 15 minutes, so I may choose to bring in 2 or 3 things at the end, but if not, you can go to this YouTube site, and you can see the compilation of TwitCasting that I did for ISTE 2014, and my ISTE Administrators PLN, and for online learning, the roundtable I did for them. Now again, here's my information. My email is here toward the bottom. Also my phone number. And my blog address is here, drmmtatum.weebly.com. And twitter.com/drmmtatum is my Twitter site. And if you happen to be coming to AMLE in Nashville, I'm actually presenting physically about TwitCasting at the AMLE on Friday, November the 7th, and I'd love to see you there. Now, normally this is where I would do question and answers, but I know that we're not meeting physically, so please feel free to send me an email at mtatum@fhu.edu or use my Google phone number, 731-879-1119. I know this has been a pretty quick session, but I've shared with you a few ways in which I would use TwitCast as a classroom teacher, as an administrator, and even in the central office, I would use it as a way to communicate with whomever I happen to be over, whether I'm the English supervisor, the supervisor of media specialist, supervisor of fifth grade. I would use it as a way to have ongoing systemic professional development. Again, thank you very much. I pray that everyone has a great day.